Hey, what's up guys? It's Jason with Gaming here. Hope you guys are having a great day. In today's video, we're going to be going over Mass Miner at Town Hall 10. Mass Miner is a great strategy for farming. It's easy to use, very efficient, and still works great without heroes. So stay tuned to the end because I'm going to be showing you multiple ways how to use this, and we'll be dropping tips throughout the entire video. And before you know it, your attack log is actually going to look like this. But before we get started, please leave a like and subscribe for more content. When you leave a like and a comment, it really helps my content get noticed by the YouTube algorithm so I can grow. So now, let's go ahead and get into it. Alright guys, I just want to give you guys a fair warning that after watching this video and trying it yourself, I don't think you will ever use another Town Hall 10 farming strategy. And the reason I say that is because it's so good and I really wish I discovered it earlier. As you can see from my attack log, this thing is insane and it actually triples pretty well without even really trying. The miners just work so good at Town Hall 10. So here's the exact attack army composition that I use. I use 3 baby dragons, 35 miners, 3 heal spells, 2 rages, and a poison. You can get whatever in the clan castle. You really don't need heroes or a clan castle to be successful with the strategy. They just make it better. And it's seriously so strong, guys. But honestly, like I said, you don't need heroes. You don't need clan castle. They just make them better. And the miners basically handle the entire base themselves. All right, so what we're going to go ahead and do now is we're going to break down a couple replays. And then we're going to do some live attacks at the end just to show some of the different bases I look for and just overall rating tips in general. So step number one in this entire raid is the funneling portion. And baby dragons are so good at funneling. They're my favorite troops to actually create a funnel with. And I chose to have 3 just because sometimes a baby dragon will get hit by an air mine or there's too many point defenses. And honestly, it never hurts to just have a backup. And as you create that funnel, what we're going to go ahead and do is you want to create a funnel so that way there is a clear path, as you can see, for the miners to enter the base as a group. Miners are a very strong troop, but only when they are together. So we're about to enter stage 2, which is the deployment of the miners. And as you can see, you will deploy them pretty close together. This is pretty easy, and in a straight line so that way they can enter the base together. And what we're about to do now is enter stage number 3, and that is spell deployment. And this is arguably the most important part of the raid because there's 2 main things that you need to watch out for, and that is the Inferno Tower and the Wizard Tower. The Inferno Tower only really cares, like it only really matters when it's a multi-target Inferno. And why I say the Wizard Tower is because the Wizard Towers are typically paired close to a gold storage, and gold storages are very high HP buildings. So you need to make sure you have a heal ready because although the Wizard Tower may not do that much damage, over a long period of time, it really adds up. So as you can see, because there's a lot of buildings in this area, pretty high hit point and overall just a lot of damage, what I went ahead and did is I dropped a heal and a rage. I typically drop my rage spells when there's a large cluster of buildings, including heroes or heroes just in general. And especially when you're in the core of the base, you want to get through it as fast as possible because typically the core bases are usually the most defended and there's usually the most damage points in a small area. So as you can see, I put the heals down, put the rage down, and even put the poison spell down to just help out the miners take out some of the heroes and the skeleton spells. So those are the 3 main steps. And right now, as you can see, I'm actually deploying my heroes. As you can see, without the heroes, I basically went through the base pretty easily, but the heroes are just going to make this much cleaner and really just guide the miners throughout the base even more. So like I said, you really don't even need heroes. It really just makes this raid so much cleaner. I've already got a ton of loot, and as you can see, the miners are going to go ahead and clean up the rest of this base. And that is a GG for some pretty good loot. Now, let's go ahead and get into the next replay and look at a different type of base. All right, so for replay number 2, we're going to have a bigger emphasis on just a different base and just some of the things to really just look out for. So one of the questions you may be asking yourself is, well, how do I pick a good place to enter? And really how I determine that is really just what is the clearest path to the core of the base. This part right here is the most important part of the base, because once you've got the core, basically it's just like, it's like the intestines of the body, you know, you got to get to that. And if you get to that, it's almost like GG, okay? So what you're gonna see me do here is I'm gonna use the baby dragons to create a wide funnel. I didn't like the corners just because corner funneling is never easy. The reason why is because if you do the corner, chances are your miter can go to the left and it can go to the right. So what we went ahead and did is we did the plan A, or the step one, which is the funneling, then we initiated step two. So as you see, miners are going in, and now there's wizard towers on both sides, and as you can see, they're paired up next to storages. So you're gonna see me have to drop some heals here. So drop the rage, because it's next to some high hit points, and really just a cluttered area. So drop the rage and the heal. Those are going in, they're living, they're surviving. Going in, dropped another rage in the core to get through all those high HP buildings. And what you're gonna see me do shortly on is I'm gonna go ahead and drop my queen at the bottom of the base just to help my miners, you know, clean up, go to the rest of the base. And as you can see, they are cleaning up very nicely, and that is a GG. As you can see, it's really not that complicated, guys. It's really just funneling correctly, putting your miners at in a good starting location, and really just using your spells accordingly. So what we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna recap one more base, and then we're gonna go ahead and do some live attacks. Let's get it. All right, guys, so I just wanna give a replay without heroes, without playing castle troops. Although I do have a wall wrecker in my composition, I don't actually end up using it. So as you can see off the bat, using the two baby dragons to funnel, and as like I said, it's always useful to have that third one. That's why I love it in the composition, just because that first one got shot down. I'm using the second one to take out that queen, and then I'm starting that phase two and going ahead and entering the base with all the miners in a straight line. And because there wasn't that much defenses here, I didn't need to use too many spells very early on. Use the rages to get through the core right here, and then as you can see, as the defenses start to clump up a little bit, gonna need to use some heal spells, especially near the splash damage, and just so many point defenses here, guys. And unfortunately, because I didn't have, or because I didn't deploy the clan castle troops or my heroes, I'm not gonna be able to three star it. But honestly, as you will see, I basically got every single resource that I needed. Like, I got over 750,000 gold, and I'm gonna get over 600,000 elixir. So as you can see, this stuff works, this strategy works. It's so useful, pretty simple to use. And now let's go ahead and finish this video off with some live attacks, and let's see what we can do. All right, guys, let's go ahead and get a search going and see if we can find a good base to attack. So, wow, off the bat, actually, we found a pretty dead base. And yeah, I think this will actually be just fine. So let's go ahead and check this out, and let's see a good place to enter. I think what we'll end up doing here is we're gonna go ahead and enter by, let's go to the bottom here. We might as well use the heroes because we got them, and we might as well use the siege machine, maybe. Let's go ahead and start with the heroes though, just to take out these enemy heroes and take care of that. But let's start with the baby dragon over here, baby dragon over there. Even though they're close together, hopefully they split, which they should do. Yep. All right, and go ahead and rage up the king. And what we're just gonna go ahead and do is just put a baby dragon there. And what we're gonna go ahead and do, guys, is we're actually gonna put the miners down right here, just to compliment the heroes a little bit, let the queen go inside, and hopefully do some work without too much trouble. So those are gonna go down. All right, pretty clean path so far, can't complain. Haven't taken too much damage, but they are gonna split. All right, I'm just waiting. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and use the first rage there. And we're probably gonna need to use the first heal. Yeah. I'm gonna use a heal there and a heal here. And what we're gonna go ahead and do actually is use another rage very shortly once it gets a little bit closer. Yeah, boom, right there. So use some patience. As you can see, there wasn't too much damage early on, but as they progressed through the base, there was different pockets where there was different damage areas. So this is definitely looking like a pretty clean 3-star, some nice loot, and it's really just being patient, guys, and just really utilizing this strategy to the mat to the fullest extent. Even though you're not going to 3-star all the time, it's not really a 3-star strategy, more or less, but honestly, it works kind of just like one. So I hope you guys really enjoyed this video, guys. It really means a lot when you guys do leave a like and subscribe. If you guys have a comment or you want me to make a video on something, please let me know in the comments. And stay tuned for more content, guys. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Thanks so much for watching.